owners of the Nikon D850, D810, D750, whatever, when they see this video all the way to the end, you're going to say, oh my god, I never thought of that when I start analyzing the ergonomics. Because I was reading the review of Lloyd Chambers of the Leica M10 and he found so many issues and problems with ergonomics and stuff. But one thing, and it was one of the minor things, the others were more serious, is this stupid dial that people accidentally press all the time, right? But let's go and see first what good ergonomics really are, let's say in an airplane.
The switches on the MD80 are kind of interesting. Every single one of them, as you look at the overhead, appears different. The fuel boost pump switches are different from the windshield wiper switches. And the emergency power switch is this huge honking switch that controls that. The seatbelt sign switch is just different than, any of the electrical switches. It's nice that when you grab a switch, you know what it is instantly. The Boeing has some of the same switches. For example, the seatbelt sign is the same as his windshield wiper switch, and all the push button for window heat, things like that, they're all the same for electrical switches and stuff. So this has a little more unique character. It looks, when you look at it, it looks more like a hodgepodge and a mess, but it actually makes a lot of sense. Everything on
it makes a lot of sense because when the buttons are different from each other, you don't need to look at them when you operate them. It takes only a couple of times to get used to them, to know what each button does just by touching it. Because you touch it, you feel its shape, you know what it is, you know the geometrical relationship between the different buttons. So let's now see the ergonomics in the four sides of the D850. First side, top right, the shutter button. And there is a ring around it with a little lip, a little tab that if you push to the right, it's going to light up all the screens and buttons. Then it's got 1, 2, 3 buttons that are not in a straight line, they're in a triangle. So you know which is which. But even if you press them accidentally, nothing will happen. Because, for example, this is the ISO button. To change the ISO, you need to keep this button pressed while you're rotating the dial. So there is no accident in this. You have to do it deliberately. The same goes for the exposure compensation. You got to use the dial. This is the movie button that works only during movie operation of the camera. So you have to have pressed another switch in the back to activate it. Top left. Any of these buttons work also with a rotating dial only. So you have to keep it pressed and rotate. So you need two hands. Impossible to change settings accidentally. This little button here, it unlocks the rotating dial to go from single shooting to continuous shooting and mirror up and so forth. So you have to push the button and rotate the dial. No accidents here. It's impossible to make accidental changes. Let's go in the back. Left side. Quick access menu. It's recessed and it's smaller than the other. Impossible to miss. Confirmation button and display buttons generally. Whatever you do with these buttons, you can press them all you want, they do nothing. You have to be either in the menu or in live view to use this button to magnify the view or this and that. Or press it to see your flash settings, and then you have to use the rotating dial at the same time, so it's always a two-button operation, right? The menu button. You press the menu appears. At any given point in time, if you press any button or any combination of buttons and you press the shutter button, the shutter takes over. It's priority. It overrides everything. So even if you press the menu button and the menu appears, but you keep pressing the shutter to take pictures, the camera takes pictures. It ignores completely. It shuts off the menu and keeps taking pictures. The shutter overrides it. So there are two ways to turn the menu screen off. One is to press the menu button twice, and the other is to just press the shutter and take the picture. It overrides it. The right side. This selector is the stiffest selector you've ever seen. You cannot accidentally move it to any direction with your palm. Try it yourselves. It's very difficult, almost impossible. you have to use a finger deliberately on either side, each side, and it's stiff. And if your palm goes over here and sits over here while you're shooting, you're gonna feel it very uncomfortable because of the raised perimeter. The center button is humanly impossible to push with your palm because it's very recessed. It's deep inside and it needs a deep push itself. It's not easy, you know, you don't just push it and it activates a little bit, you have to push it deep. These are information buttons which are overridden immediately by the shutter or any other function. This is the live view button. The live view is a deep button, which means you have to press it deep. You cannot accidentally push it because it's protected by a lip around it, you see? It has a lip around it. So you cannot accidentally push it with your palm. You have to deliberately push it and push it deep. And this is a selector that is a stiff selector to go from a movie mode to photo mode and so forth. This here, the joystick, it has a raised surface from this side where your thumb is. Your thumb is anatomically impossible to hit it. Your thumb is here. If your thumb extends, it's gonna go here, in this line, down. Unless your thumb starts growing, like you're an alien, these shapeshifters, your thumb has a certain size. It won't grow all of a sudden and go that way. It will slip and go this way on the screen. But even if you accidentally go over the joystick with your thumb, it's still kind of like a stiff joystick, and you're gonna feel the rough surface. This is the back button focus. Okay, I think I covered everything. So it is impossible at any given point in time to change settings by accident, because you need always two buttons, a button and a dial, to change settings. It is impossible to screw up the camera somehow, to, let's say, go from color to monochrome mode or something like that. It's impossible. It's always a deliberate thing. You can press all the buttons together, it doesn't matter, because you're gonna press the shutter button, it overrides everything and takes the picture. That's ergonomics.